And good afternoon to everyone. So I will now introduce the issue of biofouling from a biological point of view by showing you some of the results of a project that we have conducted a couple of years ago and some observations that are currently ongoing. So in this presentation, I will give you some background on the biofouling research at France Énergie Marine. And then we'll see what is biofouling and what are the challenges associated with this phenomenon. In the third part, I will show you the results of the synthesis of knowledge regarding biofouling along the French coast we've been conducted before. And I'll finally wrap up and discuss perspectives. So at France Énergie Marine, in the headquarters and in the Mediterranean office, we are a bunch of people being interested in biofouling with different profiles from marine biologists to structural and fluid structure engineers working within two research and development programs, the technology design and environmental integration programs. And together with our partners, the Université de Toulon, Université de Nantes, IFREMER, Université Bretagne Sud, EDF Renouvelable, Engie Green, RTE, Naval Energy, Corodis, and some others. We work at better defining and quantifying biofouling within ocean renewable energy areas, offshore French seas. So as every structure out at sea, ocean renewable energy structures are colonized by living organisms, which are grouped under the term of biofouling. So here you can see biofouling made of laminarian and green algae on the modules of the wave energy device Pelanis. On the bottom, you can see also soft corals on jackets. And in this video of the floating offshore wind turbine FloGen, which Arthur has just presented earlier, we can see some mussels that have been growing on the float of the turbine and some Asterias rubens, so some echinoderms that are actually feeding on these mussels. And close to the seafloor, we can see the mooring lines here, a big chain colonized by some calcareous worms and some fruits and hermit crabs around. So there is life around the structures. So biofouling, as previously mentioned by Arthur and Fabien, results in an increase of the structure weight, of the diameter of the dynamic cable and mooring lines, can also increase the roughness of surfaces. So there are many questions related to this issue regarding offshore renewable energy device. And Guillaume will tell you more about this effect in the following presentation. But what I would like to highlight now is the fact that it's not so easy to remove these locks because biofouling is a complex process. So in fact, when you put a structure in the sea, its surface will attract particles, polymers, a few seconds later, and soon after, bacteria colonize the surface as well and form a biofilm that complexifies the surface, where set some unicellular organisms within several days. And soon after, some larvae that develop. And along the coming weeks and months, form a mature community that you can see here on the graph. And each step and phase of this process is influenced by a number of variables, abiotic variables such as hydrodynamics, temperature, salinity, but also biotic variables such as the food availability or the predation, for example. And depending on the variation of these parameters, the biofueling change, even at the mature phases. We talk about a dynamic stage, actually. It's constantly evolving. And the variation in abiotic and biotic parameters can be linked with environmental differences across space, which in turn affect biofueling. And to illustrate this variability, I'm showing the results of a study by McLeod et al., who have surveyed buoys deployed at different places around Scotland. And on these buoys, they found very different biofueling. So some was dominated by hydrozoans, some others by these big brown algae, the laminarians, some others by mussels. So you can see that it's heavily variable. And to give another example from the Mediterranean Sea this time, let's look at this PVC plate that were deployed at different places offshore the Mediterranean Sea in the frame of the Abio Plus project. So some were deployed at 17 kilometers offshore, some others at 2 kilometers offshore. And after 3 months of immersion, the plates were differently colonized with a few algae and caprelids, so small crustaceans on this plate, and with green and red algae, and also some calcareous worms, the serpulids, on the plate that you can see at the bottom of the screen. And after 11 months, you see that the colonization looks quite different, with lots of mussels and anemones having grown on the plate, you can see at the bottom, and also some mussels that are actually eaten by some sea urchins on the plate, which appear on the top of the plate. And at these two sites, in November 2019, we also placed new PVC plates that looks at the first one at T0. And you can see that some months later, so the duration of the colonization was different from the plates that we've just seen together. The colonization looked really different as well, with mussels and anemones on the plate, which is on the top, and with lots of anemones, hydrozoans, red algae on the plate, which is at the bottom. So these results are really preliminary. The analyses are not completed yet. We especially need to measure the weight of the colonization, also the thickness, the different parameters that we've been discussed previously. But it's just nice observations that are pretty new. And what about the variation of the characteristics of biofueling, despite the species composition that we've been just talking about? So the results I would like to show you now are part of a synthesis of the available knowledge regarding biofueling along the French coast conducted within the ABIOP project. So we analyzed studies that aimed at measuring biofueling at different sites along French coast, and we extracted data presented in these studies. For example, data relative to biomass. And on this graph, you can see the wet weight of the fueling function of the depth. And the wet varies from a few kilograms to 30 kilograms, which is quite a big variation. And these results are in accordance with other studies conducted within European waters. We also extract data from biomass surveys a long time. And we can see that it varies quite a lot as well, with increase and then decrease of biomass measured a long time. And this variation might be explained by the occurrence of storms, for example, so the influence of abiotic parameters, but also the intensity of the predation, so the influence of biotic variables. Otherwise, based on a larger publication body, we also show that most of the data available regarding biofouling was gathered at relatively low depths, and that the variables that were measured within these studies, the variables that are measured the most are the number of individuals in a biofouling community, so the abundance, while there are only a few info regarding the roughness, the thickness, and the volume of the biocolonization, of the biofouling. While these variables are also important for the questions that raise in this context of ocean renewable energy. So to wrap up this presentation, the results from the synthesis I've just shown you underline that there is a lack of knowledge regarding some characteristics of biofouling, so the volume, the thickness, the roughness, especially, while we need to measure a variation for both engineering and environmental questions. And in addition, there is a lack of data at greater depths, while, for example, floating offshore wind turbines will be deployed at the 200 meter depth. And also, we lack information within environments that are not easily accessible because they are offshore, they are dynamic, while these environments are targeted by offshore renewable energy developers. And we also need measures of the colonization considering new materials and components specific to offshore renewable energy. But in order to thoroughly increase the knowledge on this matter, we need to ask what measures are really needed and at which accuracy in order to develop specific and targeted protocols to survey biofouling. And I ended up this presentation by showing you a picture of one of the divers who surveyed our installation in the Mediterranean Sea and took videos of the mooring lines of the instrumented buoy, where muscles have actually grown and well developed and reach approximately 200 millimeters of thickness. Thank you everyone for your attention.